quick announcement. Sorry if anything in our recent broadcast has offended you. That's not the point of these, but, you know, sometimes stuff slips out. That was our fault.
Feel free to tell us if you do feel offended or as if something that we've said is incorrect, and we will be sure to fix that. Thank you.
Good morning, Rams. It's Wednesday, August 28th. I'm Silas.
And I'm Keira.
Let's begin.
There is a soccer conditioning meeting today in front of the gym at 1:45 p.m.
Speaking of that, conditioning starts next week on Wednesday, September 4th, a half hour after school ends, and continues every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday.
And the senior parent night for the class of 2020 is tonight in the CAF at 6 p.m. The Balfour rep is going to be on site for cap and gown ordering. There's also senior event, graduation, and college career information. Program begins promptly at 6 p.m. See you there.
Moving on, anyone that needs to purchase a parking pass for the student parking lot should stop by the office only after school. You need to bring the following: vehicle registration, safety check, insurance card, driver license, and $20 cash. All your documents must be current. No expirations.
If you drive, then you have no problem bringing in donations to help the PTSA with their annual Savers Fund Drive. They accept clothes, shoes, hats, mittens, scarves, ties, socks, underwear, belts, towels, purses, wallets, fanny packs, bags, sheets, blankets, pillows, curtains, tablecloths, and other cloth materials. Please, no books or hard household goods.
Bring your goods to the front of our school between 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. Saturday, September 7, 2019. And then deliver it to Savers. It helps recycle goods and raise funds for the school.
Oh, good morning, my brothers. I'm Malika, and I'm here with your weather. Today is going to be a high of 90 and a low of around the mid-70s, meaning it's going to be very hot today, so make sure you drink your water out of your little hydro flask or your water bottles. Now back to the anchor.
Now for the CCRC happenings.
The following is a list of colleges and activities in the CCRC. Interested? Visit the CCRC for more information and or sign up. Open to all grade levels starting now.
August 30th, Bernard College, New York, period 6.
September 5th, University of Portland, period 5.
September 6th, Villanova University, Pennsylvania, period 4.
September 9th, University of Rochester, New York. Period 2.
This Friday, during period 6, is the briefing for the High School Work Study Program, and the National Security Agency offers to high school students. The program is for those interested in computer engineering, computer tech, business, and careers in intelligence. Visit the CCRC for a pass.
If you're more interested in the medical field, the Cano Academy explores various health career fields, shadows, and professionals. Let you gain research experience. Applications are due by September 1st. For more information, visit the CCRC.
Now, with homecoming week coming up in a couple of weeks, there's a bunch of class assemblies happening this Friday, so check out your class socials to keep up to date.
And with homecoming comes the dance. Pick up your dance form at room 113 and return it to room 113 with your payment to secure your bid. The dance is on September 21st from 5:30 p.m. to 10 p.m. Gosh, that's long. At the Honolulu Country Club. Questions? Please see Mr. Godo in room 113, please.
Now, as usual, it's time to wrap these announcements up. So here we go with the lunch.
Yay, lunch. Today, the cafe is serving
beef stew with fresh vegetables,
steamed rice,
biscuits,
steamed corn,
steamed broccoli,
fresh fruit of the day,
and milk.
And tomorrow you can feast on
Korean chicken,
steamed rice,
a whole grain roll,
fresh spinach and romaine salad,
fresh carrot sticks,
dressing,
edamame,
fresh fruit of the day,
and also milk.
For Rampage TV, I'm Silas.
And I'm Kira.
And have a ram-rousing day.
Ten-second trivia. Which of these events occurs on December 21st? first U.S. primary, start of winter, start of Hanukkah, or daylight saving time ends. The winter solstice, aka the first official day of winter, is on December 21st this year. According to the Farmer's Almanac's prediction for this winter, the U.S. is getting ready to take a ride on the polar coaster. Sadly, I didn't write that, they did. And the reason they did is because it's supposed to be cold. What the almanac calls freezing, frigid, and frosty, at least for most of America. East of the Rocky Mountains, the group says the country will see crazy swings in temperature and plenty of snow in the areas that got it last year. Negative 40 degrees Fahrenheit is possible in the Plains states. The South is expected to be chilly with average or above average precipitation. But as far as the western third of the country goes, the Farmer's Almanac predicts business as usual. Cool temperatures with normal amounts of rain and snowfall for 2020. This particular almanac has been around since 1818. Its predictions are based on a secret formula that factors in everything from sunspots to the positions of the planets to the moon's effects on tides. And it calls its long-range predictions, quote, amazingly accurate. Can we get away, far away? Let's leave this place. Will you come with me? Are you down to turn your world around? It's you and me tonight.
31 seconds, and we're going for auto sequence start.